specific to human elements. Not all, I have been saying, but many. The practice of yoga unites the brain, then mind, and then body overall. These all three things together. Okay? So yoga historically is not only spiritual discipline, but has been used as clinically now as an alternative and alternative medicine aspect in the Western world, as a therapeutic intervention. So if you see the neurobiology of the yoga, so what happens, the brain is having, there's two parts of the brain, central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. Central nervous system is having brain and spinal cord, which lies here in the vertebral column. And beyond that is everything is in the peripheral nervous system. So peripheral nervous system is having network of nerves and ganglia throughout the body. So they go, you know, nerve fibers goes to the fingers, lower extremity, upper extremity, even abdomen and everywhere. Now, when we have a stretch and different body postures, these neuronal aspect or neuronal transmission, where the signal is going on, electrochemical signal goes on in the neuron, is in the proper state. And then there's an autonomic nervous system of the body which controls the internal organs, which is not under our control, like digestive system, breathing system, which is having again two parts, sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system. So parasympathetic, sympathetic, and overall autonomic nervous system is having better positive effect by the yoga. So it has effect on by this neurobiological aspect. And also neurotransmitters are the signal which takes our signal from finger to ear and taking command of my body for any motor function in the finger or writing or anything. These neurotransmitters are in a proper channel in the body. So this is the, anyway, neurobiology is the least studied subject so far. So out of 14 organ systems of the body which we study in MBBS or medical sciences, like digestive system, respiratory, gynecology, like that, neurobiology is the least studied because we don't understand and we are not yet understand total brain. And mind is still different, okay? Mind is even beyond that. So it is the least studied subject. She's Elizabeth Blackman, one of my favorite scientists. And she's Nobel Prize winner 2009. And after that, she was working on telomeres, which are the chromosomes. So we all know that we have a 23 pair of chromosomes, and each chromosome corner ends are having telomeres one part. So every time a cell duplicates, multiplication takes place, the DNA duplication doesn't go till the corner. So telomeres get shorter and shorter and shorter by as we grow older, and that is one reason of the aging phenomenon in the person. How we get old, how our skin gets, you know, not having tenacity. If you close your ear and eyes, then your all five senses are off now. You imagine. And just do humming sound. So you are now internally reverberating that sound in your body. Now just imagine, like you do. Close your ear and eyes to feel.
Oh, you should try it. The sound inside is like, it's really strong. If you have to close your ear. Close your ear and then close your eyes and then use the om sound, om, and then you can hear like it's the sound.
It's good for the head. Back pain is one of the common among office people nowadays. And Gomukhasana and Prati Chakrasana. So this is Gomukhasana. Go is like a cow. So it's like this situation. So, when you do this, then your vertebral column, which is your spinal cord, comes into the standard format of this curvature. So this is having five segments, cervical, thoracic, lumbar, sacral and caudal. And lumbar part is here, somewhere here, L1 to L5, if you remember the medical. And this L1 to L5, which is having lumbar means, in Latin it's lumbar means loin actually. So lumbar part is having maximum weight of my torso, of our body torso. So lumbar part is inward projection. So this comes in a standard format. This is the biology of it. So this is that, you know, Gomukhasana. This is the situation in alternatively like this. Okay. And then this is Pratichakrasana, this way. This way. Again, you are exercising your body column. And this is the beginning of Pratichakrasana. So this is slight variation.
Thank you.